promise one thing that can possibly happen.
There are something. They asked me to call you.
Go and hear what they have decided. Just be careful. I'm going to lie. You follow me.
Considering your condition as a pregnant woman, we have decided that Ejiofor here should go to the city with you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. My goodness. I'm moving. Thank you, God.
Thank you, too.
May God reward every one of you for standing by this little girl throughout this time period.
Thank you very much. You see, woman, our in-law, it is a collective responsibility. And so we cannot shy away from it.
We can't abandon her. Yes. I believe all will be well.
Yes.
No matter how hard it is to believe, I know in my heart that all shall be well.
Amen.
It is well that ends well.
Yes,
Lord. My elders, please let me go outside.
Oh, you are free to do that, okay? Eh? You are very free.
You want to go?
Beg me, sister.
Okay, please.
It's all right.
Yes. Ben. Who is Ben?
Ben?
Yes, sir. I heard that. I heard it in my dream just now.
Dream? You only came in to collect the medicine you take after we eat. You weren't sleeping.
I'm sure I had this dream. Just now, I heard that name in my dream. Ben.
That's not a dream. That is memory. You are beginning to recall things from your past. Well, keep it up. Hold it. Don't force it. It's a gradual process. It's fine. Come on, let's go.
There used to be actually, but I guess we found a solution to it, and that is what I've come to discuss with you.
Okay.
You know the Aloji power plant supply contract I told you about?
Yes.
They're insisting on not paying anything until every supplier has shown a considerable level of capacity to handle the project. They want every supplier to show a commitment of about 30%. About 8 million naira, and of course, we don't have that now in the company's coffers now.
So, what do we do?
We look at two options. One is to sublet the contract to another company and make minimal profit without any risk at all. That sounds good, but our advisors are of the opinion that if we do that, it was going to rubbish our pedigree in terms of subsequent contracts from NIPP and even from other companies.
Okay.
So we now consider the option of borrowing to make up the initial 30% supply. Mr. Dixon spoke to a private microfinance organization. The owner happens to be a manager at the Zenith Bank. They are willing to give us 8 million.
But you know they will be demanding a collateral.
Yes, actually, that's why we're having this conversation. But the assurance I have, with which I would suggest that we go ahead and borrow, is that NIPP gives a post-debit check once you submit. You make the pro forma invoice of your prospective supply available and then verify it. And the account is domiciled with Zenith Bank. And so our agreement with the owner of the microfinance organization, who is also managing the bank, is that once they give the post considered check, he can honor its prior appointed date. Take the money and return the collateral to us. That way, we are sure of not running into any form of trouble.
So, what's collateral are they demanding?
Sumto is a big one. And I'm of the opinion that we must take a critical look at it. Let's just be sure of what we're doing before putting up our thumbs on it.
I ask again, what is the collateral?
Yes, Bayo. Are you assuring us that the wife I ever met you before or know that you don't work with a bank?
No, man. Come on. I only met her once during their wedding day. And it was rather too busy and rowdy. She couldn't have remembered.
Couldn't Ben mention to her that you're a common syndicate operator?
Come on, man. Why are we adding so much ado to nothing? Don't all kinds of people work in the bank these days?
Wow. Really? Even engineers.
I mean, it's that bad.
What's this?
Oh, sorry, Mr. Anduka. I received a mail from the NIPP acknowledging the receipt you made of the withdrawal of our bill.
Janet.
Mr. Anduka.
How does she keep calling you Mr. Anduka, Mr. Anduka? Are you not her boss?
She's very stupid. She's such a stupid girl. You've not seen anything. That's how she addresses everyone around here. It's either Miss This or Mr. That. Janet.
Mr. Luca, sir.
I told you categorically not to disrupt this meeting, didn't I? As a matter of fact, I asked you to remain on your desk to ensure that you don't get tempted into disrupting this meeting.
Oh, you actually did, Mr. Luca. Sir.
Sorry. Oh, Mr. Sir. This girl, the Chris, not be so you talk.
Oh, Bayo. The most annoying part of it is that Soto insisted that she must be retained in this office. If not, Admiral had her fired!
Ndoka, please pardon Janet. I believe that she may have interrupted us in a good faith. So Janet, what is the issue?
Mr. Dixon, thank you very much for your kind intervention.
Go ahead and say your rubbish and get out of here.
Sorry, I know you like you hardly go through your mail or read them. I decided to make a copy of it and bring it to you so you go through.
No. Or go to it. Get out!
Oh, thank you very much. Sorry.
This girl now complete here. Yeah, girl, look. What's all in the workshop?
So, go ahead, sir.
Like I said, I had to squeeze out time out of my busy schedule to be here with Mr. Dixon and your brother-in-law just because of the pressure for them to keep every of our information transparent to you.
Yeah, it's the key. Transparency is very key.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Dixon. So now, sir, what are you saying collateral for the loan will be?
The company itself. I'm afraid so. But really, you have nothing to worry about. As in the company, you are supplying the items, they maintain an account with my bank. Since their practice is to write a post-dated check, once the supply is confirmed by the suppliers, I have agreed to do for Mr. Dixon's sake and for your brother-in-law, who have put so much passion into making sure that this deal pushed through, is that I will honor the check predate. Accept the credit I'm giving to you guys, release your collateral to your bank, so that even if they end up deciding not to honor the check, it will now be between them and the bank. Because I must have acted in the name of the bank. That way, your asset is secure.
Can't you protect something else other than the company? Like cars or even land?
Mommy, what we are talking about is fiscal risk management. If you had been a keen observer of market indicators and the capital market, you realize that there is what we call credit crunch at the moment. Even the big banks are scared to lend money. So, what my organization is offering you, But in doing that, we have to assure the security of our investors' capital. That aside, on a personal note, I even accepted to do more than is required to make sure that you are not locked in this deal in any way by taking a risk of paying you the check before the due date.
We quite appreciate everything, but can't you, I mean, at least cut down on the collateral level? Possibly you know, 50 to 60% of the company's assets rather than the whole company.
Yes, the company percentage or like non-listed assets like cars or land, like he said.
No, our company cannot go below this. If you are going to sound that you're not even sure of the contract in the first place.
No, not at all. Please, Sontuan, can I see you by the name?
Sure.
Mr. Dixon, let me see that.
Please remember I left it back.
No, we are aware of that. We are very brief. Please.
When this deal finally goes through, what do we do with the
company? We will continue running the business.
Eh?
Is it? You know they use your head. You are who go run the company.
No,
for you. Is it not the collateral that will be sold to recover the money for the loan? After only for 6 months,
once the 6 months elapses, we will sell it off and use the money for something else. Because if you continue running the company and they ask you, how come you're still running it when the debtors ought to have taken over, what will you tell them?
You tell them to decline.
Okay? There is your head. I'm on a bottle of chilled coke.
Stop talking about getting off! Mommy, please, I'm busy just helping get here.
with all I could to stay back and come with us today here. But he insisted on going, promising that he will come back to check on me for in about a week or two.
So, how did he say he found him?
He lives by the bank of Iyoko in Ogun. He said two young fishermen from the area found him while they were fishing along the river banks. That he looked pale when he was brought from the river basin with both his hands and legs tied that he had a serious head injury. He also said that he was unconscious for the first 2 days when he started treating him, and that he was only able to get up from the bed after 6 days of treatment. According to him, as at then, he could not move steadily or speak with coordination. But all those are in the past now, just that he does not have any single memory of the past. Don't be scared now. This is your brother, body and soul.
Omejofa, look at your brother. Uncle Mwoke can no longer remember any one of us.
They say kidnappers gave him serious head injury, which wiped out all of his memory.
Broken, it's me. It's your brother. It's a good job for
Ibi. Ibi.
That is the only thing he says for now. Since we were in the car, he has been asking for the man.
God, may your name be praised. So, Papa, how was the man able to locate you?
He said the spirit led him to me, that he saw me in a kitchen searching around for pen. And he man, that baboon, that Chico's in one, he said, life. And since, after the burial, I have been sleeping with one eye closed. Because I know that a day like this will eventually
come. I love you for you. This is your son. George, this is your son. Why are you doing this, your father? Your father again.
Yes, ma'am. He doesn't need to remember his marriage, not to talk of recognizing his wife.
Think that he's going to remain like that forever. That he would never regain his memory.
Well, I don't know. I don't know.
This is not good for us. This is not good at all.
Yeah, I know, bro. I know. And that's why I'm thinking of force clearing.
Clearing to where?
Abroad, of course.
What happens to him? How will he ever come back if he remembers what happened to him?
Brother, that's the only infinite option available.
Look, bro, you need to fix this. You live there. Let's work out a way of taking care of him, finally.
Brother!
Okay.
Hey, brother! You really need to help me! You just have to help me, please! Hey! You just have to help me! Agui, my friend! My friend is dying! Hey, Agui, oh God!
Who's Agui?
Agui, my friend! Agui, one of those guys you met with me the first day you met us! Hey! We just came here for a phone hunting! And then he got bitten by a very poisonous snake! He's got his son, his son says.
Where is he?
He said here, he said.
Oh. Okay, don't panic. Let me pass quick.
Eh? Alright. Alright. Hey, Agio. Hey, okay. Hey. Hey. Hey, God. Hey!
It's okay, don't panic, don't panic. Yeah?
Say,
come and show me where it is.
Hey!
Don't panic, it's okay. Hey. Where's the person now?
He's here.
Hey! 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 Hey!
Are you drunk? What is the meaning of this?
Exactly the question I wanted to ask you. Now answer me, you occultic and ogboni man.
What evil spirit did you keep in that occultic house you built that you so willingly and freely gave us that has been tormenting my brother and I?
What nonsense are you talking about, my friend? What occultic spirit? What are you doing?
Talking about my... Hey! Hey, him up!
Ogbechofu. Ogbechofu, he slapped me. What the?
Oh, what?
Are you crazy? Come, man. Come!
Okay. This, given the present development.
Yeah, I'll work on that. But in the interim, I'm making plans of leaving in case anything goes so bad. And I will pull off the deal of that company as early as Monday.
Just do whatever you can. Be hyperactive, hypervigilant, and strong. Monitor, watch. Just do whatever you can to be on top of whatever information and events that is going on there.
But hey,
yes.
Don't tell Agri and Gentle about this, because they might panic and complicate things for us.
My head is still on top of my shoulder. Just put an eye on your head.
All right, dear. Regards to mom, yeah?
Sure. She'll be here.
Does that pose any problem for us in any way?
No, it doesn't pose any problem. He lost his memory entirely. In fact, his memory is so blank, very empty.
That means we will continue with our plan next tomorrow.
Yeah, I guess so. But you have to study him closely in case of any change. Because people with memory loss problem do recover from time to time.
Yeah, but it doesn't take just this. I spoke to a doctor friend of mine. And he told me that their recovery is possible, but it takes long stretch of time, and the memory comes bit by bit. It doesn't just come like a flashback into the patient's head.
His case is even worse because the herbalist that treated him warned that he must not be taken to any orthodox medical practitioner or exercise until the herbal content that was administered to him was reduced drastically. If not, he may die of complication. And that is what ruled us out of taking him to a new physician yet.
So far, nobody knows exactly what happened to him.
Mr. Ben is such a nice man. I mean, he couldn't have wronged anyone.
Maybe it was a kidnap case. And something went wrong. They decided to throw him into the river just to conceal all the evidence. But what becomes of the corpse you were buried in?
My uncles have started the traditional rituals required to exhume the corpse. A strange corpse is not buried in one's compound until there is a connection whatsoever with the corpse. And I guess they must have involved the police. And they gave go-ahead order to exhume the corpse.
Who be that? Who be that?
Good morning, Mr. Jackson.
Good morning, Mr. Don't just miss me. Did you hear all the rest? Even on a Saturday.
Janet, what in heaven's name are you doing here?
Oh, I left some work undone yesterday. I don't want it to spill till Monday. And Monday I want to start work with a fresh and new frame of mind.
Oh yeah, Missy, come they go now. I mean, get on the Missy, come they go now.
I'm sorry, Mr. Bayo, if I broke you. I'm very sorry, sir.
Janet! Sir. This place. Get out! Go!
Oh, you mean I should go home or go back to my office and continue my work?
Mary, mother of God. Get out!
Oh, calm down, sorry. I presume you want me to go back to my office. Sorry.
Oh, God. What are you doing?
I'm beginning to suspect this girl. Exactly. For real, I'm beginning to suspect this girl.
Are you sure you didn't go by those?
Well, Mr. Bayo, everything is all right, except for the part regarding the payment of the postdated check.
Oh, come on, madam. Do you expect me to add that in the written agreement? What I promised to you people is banking malpractice. You want me to write that down?
How else do you make sure that you will do what you promised now?
It's a fiduciary issue. It has to do with absolute trust.
It's all right. Please excuse me. Hello?
Hello, Mom.
Yes, Papa.
Is the boss there with you?
Yes, he's here with me.
Okay, please, can I speak with him?
What do you mean, can you speak with him? You know he doesn't talk.
Oh, sorry, I know. Okay, just ask him if he's ready.
I should ask him if he is ready.
Tell him yes.
Trying to remember all his banking encounters in our bank.
I also remember you not working in that. Baby, open the door.
Did you just call me baby?
I do not remember. Open the door.
Ben, are you okay?
You are my mother.
Yes, I am. Yes. Yes, I am.
Maybe you open the door.
Please.
Please, whoever is at the door should come. The door is open.
Boss. Okay. Sir. Well, please. The answer. Officer! Call it.
An innocent man, an innocent young man. Oh, una gataka job na bufo. You will suffer more than job. You will suffer more than job. Officer, take this away. Before I do something stupid, and all of you will blame you. Take him away.
Brother, please forgive me.
Did I hear you say forgive? Is he forgiven?
and as if that wasn't enough, you threw him inside the river so that no one would find his corpse. Okay?
Oh, that's the height of everything. Whose idea was that? You?
It wasn't me.
Who was it? Tell me, who was it? Who was it? I'll bust your tummy now.
It was not me. It was not me.
God, I just killed my brother. I just killed my brother. I'll be here and be gentle.
My friend, will you shut up? Will you shut up? You're talking about you and your brother. That thing done almost killed me. Look at what that thing done did to me. Look at what that thing done did to myself.
Gentle, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for the blow, but this is not what we planned. We didn't plan to kill him, did we?
Yes.
We didn't.
Yes, yes. All we wanted is to force him to confess what he did to the house. Then get the elders to banish him for diabolism. All we get was what? Attack. He gave us no other option.
Hi. Enough, enough, enough. Enough of all this, enough. Enough of all this argument. We just killed a man. Hey, we just killed a man. All we should be talking about here is how to save our neck. What do we do? What do we do, bro? Ben, what do we do?
Maybe the only way to save our neck is for us to make sure his corpse is never found.
How is that possible?
Let us bury him anywhere here.
See, I beg. I look at strength. It better look who carry that in body. Go to the one for that river over there. Make fish. Chop, and that is the rest of his.
Send them for that way we talk, and we send them for the good people.
Hey, it's my brother, eh? Robin. It's my brother.
Just come look at the go now.
To take the call to his wife and then take his car to the city where it was later found. So even if the corpse the police found is his, nobody can trace it to us. So calm down. Calm down. Follow them to the station. Make sure you don't say or do anything that will get them suspicious. You fuck up on your own.
So we are not involved in the kidnap and attempted murder saga. Please, sir.
Yes, you are right. But you are involved in a conspiracy to defraud.
And another crime. By the time you have been handled by one of our teams, you have yourself to blame. Take them away!
Thank you.
of evil. This world is full of battle. No matter how good you are, many will still call you by your name and look for a way to bring you down. But to end is human, and to forgive Oh,